Hi YouTube friends, it's Tom here. Hope you're all doing well. Join me because today we're making another paracord bracelet and this one incorporates hex nuts. So for this one we're going to need a pair of scissors, 140cm and 250cm of 550 paracord. Here we have 18 5/16 hex nuts and we're also going to need a lighter. So start off by finding the centre of both cords. Here on the left we have the shorter cord and here on the right we're using the long cord. And with the short cord, start off just by making a loop. And then I'm going to cow hitch this cord to the loop. So feed it through. Take it around the back. And then pull those two cords through that bottom loop. And we can just tighten that cow hitch up. And adjust this loop here so it's about 1 centimeter, which is around about half an inch. So I'm going to start this one off by feeding a couple of hex nuts onto my right cord. So just slide those hex nuts on all the way to the base. And I'm going to take that right cord over to the left. And now I'm going to take my left cord here. And I'm going to feed it through the hex nuts going in the opposite direction. So just feed it through both nuts, pull it all the way through. And I've also just melted the ends and rolled them into a point to make them go through the nuts a little bit easier. And now these two centre cords I want to bring to the top side. So I'm just going to pull those through the loop. So those centre cords are to the front now. I'm going to space these two nuts out a little bit. Take these centre cords around the back and straight through the centre. One side and then the other. And then we just need to tighten this up. Just make sure it's nice and neat. And now I'm going to take these two outer cords and cross them over behind those two centre cords. And I'm going to tie a clove hitch with each cord. So I'll start here on the right. I'll bring that cord through the loop there on the right. And now I'm going to cross this over. I'm going to bring it up through the centre. And I'm going to tuck it through its own loop here. And then pull that all the way through. So that's one clove hitch. I'm going to do the same on the other side. So that cord, through the loop there on the left. Pull it through. Cross it over, and then up through the centre. It's also going to run underneath that diagonal. So tuck it underneath that diagonal there, and then pull it all the way through. And now we can just tighten these up. So I just like to pull the outer strands, and then to tighten the clove hitch, I'll pull on those diagonal bars, and then pull the slack through. And just make sure this is nice and tight. Okay, we can feed on another couple of hex nuts. So grab another couple and feed them onto your cord. All the way through. Take that cord to the other side. Now with the left cord, go through those two nuts in the opposite direction. Now I just want to bring these two centre cords to the top, so I'm going to feed them through the loop. Spread those nuts out, and then take the cords around the back and through the centre. And the same with the left side, through the centre, and tighten up. Okay, with the outer strands, I want to cross them over the back again. So to the rear of those two centre strands. And again, we're going to tie clove hitches. So starting here on the right, through the outer loop. Cross it over towards the centre. And it's going to go around through the centre, and then underneath that bar there. So underneath, and then pull it all the way through. and repeats that for the left side. Around and through that left loop. Cross it towards the centre. And bring it around and up through the centre there. And then underneath the diagonal. Pull that all the way through. And again, we can tighten these up. So the next stage would be to feed another couple of hex nuts on the outer cords, and then just alternate between the hex nuts and tying the flow pitches until you get all the way down the bracelet. Once you get down to the bottom, we just need to cut off these excess pieces at the side. So, cut them off, singe them with a lighter. And just press that nice and flat, so it doesn't pull back through the knot. And we can repeat that over the other side. Cut off the excess, and then singe that off. Okay, now we just need to tie a button down here at the bottom. So I'm going to start with the right cord and form an underhand loop. And then with the left cord, I'm going to form an overhand loop, bringing it over the top of the two centre strands. Going to go around the back and then up through the right loop and the left cord, down to the front and down through the left loop. And just pull that tight. And then we can cut and singe the excess cords. So I've cut and singed the button now, and that's your finished bracelet. If you like this kind of thing, feel free to hit the subscribe button, and as always, thanks for watching, I like you all, and I'll see you on the next video.